Today I'm tackling my tiling project here at the Home Depot. Steve's got me all set up to actually tile this wall, and I'm really looking forward to it. And Steve, you've got some great tips when it comes to the prep work for tiling.
Yeah, absolutely. It's kind of like we were saying, for the customer, we want them to be able to experience a good project. We don't want you to get messed up and basically end up having to rip tiles off or go buy more stuff. So Kat's actually going to set some tile for me, and I'm going to kind of describe what it is we're doing.
Excellent. And you wanted to talk about the measuring and actually finding out where I should put my tile.
Yeah, absolutely. So in this particular case, we have a wall here that has a certain dimension. So it's very important that before we start, we get some tiles and we basically dry fit. So we go along our wall to see, are we going to get to a point where I'm going to be a little tiny 1-inch piece?
Right.
Okay. Knowing that will determine where I start to set my tile.
Okay. And we should actually start setting them in the center of the wall then to be able to evenly space them all.
Absolutely. If we start in the center, we'll actually come out and we'll have even cuts on both sides.
All right. Well, you've already prepped it for me and I've got my grout here ready. Now, why is this one kind of that beveled edge?
Okay. What we need to do is we need to get a consistent thickness of the setting agent.
Okay.
So by using this V-notch trowel, we're actually going to get a nice even set of ridges, which means that the depth of the glue is the same for the whole surface.
All right. And how much should I actually be putting on here?
What we're trying to do is to get full coverage. So where we're putting the tile, we need glue in every single spot.
All right. So there's no such thing as too much.
No, you're doing a fantastic job, because the V-notches are actually going to determine how much glue is actually going to go onto that section.
Okay, and does direction matter?
Not really. If you want to be a little artistic and go vertical, it's entirely up to you.
Excellent.
Even do some circles if you like.
Oh, fun. I can do some swirls on my wall. Okay, so is that enough grout there?
You're doing a fantastic job. So that's a perfect job.
Okay.
Now, one of the things we will need to do is, because we're putting a new tile up here, we need to get a consistent space on the grouting. So you're going to be using
that?
You're going to place the tile just above and just to the right of the existing tile.
Okay.
You're going to use these little 1/8 inch spacers, and we're actually going to set them vertically on the tile.
Okay, so not flat in the corner like that. We would actually go this way.
And then you're going to push the tile down until it meets that spacer.
And how long will this actually stay kind of wet and tacky?
You've got about 30 minutes or so to actually move things around.
So don't go for lunch.
No, if you go for lunch and come back, you're actually going to have some hardened material which you're going to have to basically break off.
All right. How'd I do?
Did a fantastic job. Yeah, absolutely. One thing that we probably should always do is that when you're tiling, always check to see if your tiles are actually flat. So just get a straight edge and just basically put it across the tile and see if there's any gaps. If there are, at this time, you can just push a little bit, just to make sure it's nice and flat.
Excellent.
We don't want the tiles kind of all wobbly.
Another great tip. And for lots more great tips, tune in to the next time we check back in here at the Home Depot with Steve.